A very obvious way to define a subspace associated to a matrix A is to take the span of the columns of the matrix, because any span is immediately a subspace. But that is what we did already. This yields the column space of A. We can also associate another subspace to a matrix, the so-called null space. This null space will, just as the column space, allow us to get a better feeling for what a subspace actually means. And just as with a column space, the null space also has an interpretation in terms of linear transformations, as you may see later. But this null space is even more important for us. It will allow us to do computations with eigenvectors, also a subject of later videos. So we have at least three good reasons to study the null space of a matrix. Suppose we have an M times N matrix A. So what is the null space? Well, it's a set of vectors x which satisfy the equation A times x equals 0. So null A is a set of vectors x which have to be in Rn, because you have to be able to compute A times x, and A is an M times N matrix, such that A times x equals 0. So if you have a vector x, is it in the null space or not? Compute A times x. If you get 0, it is in the null space. If you don't get 0, the vector is not in the null space. Now, we see that null A is a subset of Rn, because if you want to be able to compute A times x, you need a vector in Rn, otherwise you cannot do the computation at all. Second question, is this a subspace or not? That is not so clear, it's not a span. So how can we check whether we have a subspace or not? Well, we need to check those three properties again. It's the only way to see whether it satisfies the properties or not. Does it satisfy these three properties? Then null A is a subspace. Does it not satisfy one of the three or more? And it is not a subspace. So let us check. First one, is the zero vector in the null space? Well, let's try. If we compute A times the zero vector, I get 0 times the first column of A plus 0 times the second column of A until 0 times the last column of A, which yields 0 plus 0 plus 0 vector equals the zero vector. So that's correct. Zero vector is indeed in the null space of A. Then, if U and V are in null A, then the sum also has to be in null A. So let's take a U and a V in null A. That means that A times U equals 0 and A times V equals 0. Then I wonder, what about A times U plus V? Is this sum also in the null space? Well, A times U plus V equals A times U plus A times V, because we are at linear algebra, so we can work out the brackets like this. Simplify it like this. And then we know A times U equals 0 and A times V equals 0. So we get 0 plus 0 equals the 0 vector. And indeed, A times U plus V is also the 0 vector. So second property is also satisfied. Let us go on to the third property. So suppose I have some U in the null space. So A times U equals 0, and some scalar C, C and R, for example. Then we compute A times C times U, because we want to know whether C times U is also in the null space. Well, A times C times U is a matrix times scalar times vector. But I can also compute it like C times A times U. We can take the scalar out, it is just a vector. So that becomes C times A times U. But A times U equals the zero vector. And some scalar times the zero vector is, of course, still the zero vector. So third property is also satisfied, which means that we now have established that, indeed, the null space is also a subspace.